Corruption of Blood by Robert K. Tanenbaum. Read by Traber Burns. To those blessings in my life, Patty, Rachel, Roger, and Billy. The Congress shall have power to declare the punishment of treason, but no attainder of treason shall work corruption of blood or forfeiture except during the life of the person attainted. United States Constitution, Article 3, Section 3. Author's Note. Since it is a matter of record that the author was at one time counsel to the House of Representatives Select Committee on Assassinations and charged with investigating the assassination of President Kennedy, the reader may wish to know whether the present volume tells, at last, the real story. As is inevitable with a work of this type, the answer must be ambiguous. On the other hand, much of the documentary evidence mentioned here actually exists, or did exist at one time. The author observed it with his own eyes. Also, of course, some of the characters mentioned are historical personages, either identified by name or thinly disguised, although they may not have done or said the things attributed to them herein. The reconstruction of the assassination itself, as given here, accords with the facts as known to the author and available in the public record, although not necessarily with the conclusions of the Select Committee. On the other hand, obviously, no one named Butch Karp was ever involved in the work of the House Select Committee in 1976. Despite superficial similarities, the author and Butch Karp are different people, or rather, the author is a real person, while Mr. Karp is not. As to the real story of the assassination of John Kennedy, the author remains unsure, as are we all, as in all probability we shall ever be. The assassination has receded into mythology and has become, like the tales of the Old West and the lives of secular saints like Washington and Lincoln, fair game for the fabulist, the moralist, and the entertainer. Thus, in the present work, the shadows thrown by various culprits, which we perceived vaguely through a fog of deception nearly 20 years ago, have been resolved into sharp focus by artifice. In short, what you are about to read is, merely and entirely, a work of fiction, based on a real event, like the Warren Report. In my opinion, of course. Chapter 1. Nearly all Americans above a certain age can recall where they were the moment they learned of the assassination of John F. Kennedy. A much smaller number can recall where they were when they discovered who really did it. One of these few was sitting in a dripping raincoat in a reading room on the fifth floor of the Lowinger Memorial Library at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C., on a rainy April day in the year 1977. On the wooden table before him was the sort of hinged cardboard box, the size and shape of a large book, that attorneys use to keep together all the material connected with some legal combat, a literal case. Within it were several dozen typed pages, including a letter from a United States senator, several memoranda from the files of the Central Intelligence Agency and the Federal Bureau of Investigation, a thick packet of handwritten notes on lined yellow paper, two bank books, a small ledger, some photographs and clippings, a tape cassette, and a reel of 8mm home movie film. There was also a sealed olive jar full of alcohol in which floated a chunk of human flesh. The man shivered and stood to remove his sopping raincoat. A young woman, 4 seats down at the long table, glanced up at him from her thesis research, American Policy in Honduras, 1922 to 1939, and then, a moment later, gave him a longer look, for the reading she was doing was tedious, and he was not an ordinary-looking man. He was very tall, for one thing, a bit over 6'5". His body, in its damp and rumpled dark suit, was broad-shouldered and rangy. He walked over to a display case and seemed to stare unseeing at a selection of colonial maps, and she could see that he walked with a slight limp.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.